Hey guys, perfect timing. I got my video first one up. You can see the time is basically counting down. If you can see it, right here's the time. I've been on here for 30 minutes. And for the 30 minutes, I thought I was gonna get my dishes done. Well, I didn't. I prepped my onions and my peaches. Peaches look like poopy, but here are the peaches. They got brown or whatever, but it's all good. They're good. They're yummy. Every single one of them's yummy. Okay, I've got my spoons ready. I have a bunch of... Oh, God, guys. I don't know. Can you see this? And I'm trying to... Anyway, I have spoons prepared for me to test. I don't like double dipping, especially if I'm going to share my dish. I think that's gross. That's just me. Many people have no problems with it. They're like, it cooks out all the nasties and all that stuff. Well, I don't like that. I think that's gross. That's why I am very hesitant to take any food from anybody, because I don't like double dipping. So that's just me. Anytime that I cook, I cook with my hair up. There are times where I accidentally forget to do that, which is really rare. That's not a good thing. And I always have my utensils here. So it's one sip or taste or a fork, and it's in the sink, and I get another thing. That's me. So anyway, I'm going to look at this. This looks really good. Like I said, this has been cooking the 30 minutes. I am going to try it. I did put an additional, let me look, you see what it looks like. I put an additional salt in it. I didn't think it tasted right. Kids at school say, you're a saltaholic. No, I'm not a saltaholic. However, I do like to have sodium bring out the wonderful flavors. So what I'm gonna do is, I got a little bit of everything in this taste here. It's hot. Hot. But so darn tasty. Heck yeah. Okay. So now you take your peaches and you take your red onions and you put it in here and you cook this. And it says you're not supposed to cook it for long, but guess what, guys? This is going to be multiple servings, so. But for the initial serving, so I got my peaches, my onions in here. And I'm going to cook this a little bit high, so we're going to simmer. I am going to cook it for 5 minutes, I believe. So I'm going to put the timer on for 5 minutes. And then as I am doing this, I won't let you, it won't be 5 minutes and you're just going to sit here and do nothing. So 5 minutes, okay. Seems like a long time, it's not. Just want to say that this recipe came from Food Lion. So a lot of times, hold on a minute, in the world. Excuse me. Okay, that's on there. I'm gonna turn this up to a simmer. All right, so what I do, a lot of times I'm very lazy, and if I don't feel like going online and getting a recipe, or if I don't feel like doing the recipe that my students did that day, then I will go to Food Lion, sit in the parking lot, and pick a recipe out that I will do. Usually the recipe that I get from Food Lion is one that lasts me for a couple of days, especially if I am not sharing it. So this is like a meal that is, so I, what I'm trying to say as far as budgeting is concerned. So I buy the initial ingredients, and yes, it may be a $20 bill or a $30 bill. However, it lasts me numerous days. So so that's one thing. And what you do when you get onto Foodline app, by the way, is not sponsoring me. It's nothing to do with me at all. But get the Foodline app, you save a lot of money, and you take your recipes and you hit put on your shopping cart. It goes on your shopping cart, and every ingredient you need is there. If you have it at home, you just hit, okay, got it. If you don't have it, you get it. So everything is there. It's really cool. I just love the Foodline app. Plus, there's a lot of coupons. There's a lot of savings. There's a lot of everything. So I highly recommend that. And so that's what I did. That's what I did with this. I was tired. Excuse me. This was Sunday. Sunday, I was tired. I don't remember all of what happened on Saturday and Sunday. Oh, okay. So I was getting back from my break, my spring break, and I was tired and I didn't know what I wanted to do. So I looked up two recipes. And I used those recipes for this whole week. The bill was $30, but $30 lasted me the whole week. I made a really, it was my personal thing. I made a ziti the very first night. It was just a plain ziti with cheese and everything else. And then I ate that for a couple nights. And then the leftovers turned into baked ziti, which was really good. And those leftovers I ended up sharing with a co-teacher of mine. And then I had this dish. And it is currently Thursday night. And I need to eat. I need to eat this. So it's really economical to use that Foodline app and to... Well, I'm single, by the way. So... That's another thing. This lasts me a long time. All right. So that's that. And I have one more minute and we're simmering and all that stuff. So I, in 1 minute, I'm going to stir it because I'm pretty sure it's at 5 minutes. Stir it, taste it. What else? I think that's it as far as this is concerned. This is very healthy. It's vegetarian protein. So if you're a vegetarian, or if you're thinking about being a vegetarian, or if you disagree with vegetarian lifestyle because you don't get the right right nutrition, that's bull. You do. Okay, I have plenty of protein in here. I have beans. I have black beans and red beans. That is your protein. So don't let someone tell you you can't be a vegetarian because you're not going to get the protein, okay? Number one. Number two, you're saving an animal's life. Every time you don't eat an animal, you're saving someone's life, some baby's life, some animal's life, okay? I don't know if you've ever seen the slaughterhouses or seen any of that. It's heart-wrenching. It's heart-wrenching, heart-wrenching, okay? Now, I am going to tell you, I do eat meat. I know it bothers me that I eat meat, but I do. Let me get off of this. We're gonna get off of there. Let me do this. And I may do a video on the eating meat thing. So I'm not blowing you off, guys. Okay, so we finally have our chili. Okay, our chili looks very yummy to me. Very, very, very yummy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to absolutely pick out a peach. All right. So my tasting spoon, and I'm going to pick out a peach, a bean, and everything. It's got everything in it. It's very hot. That is some tasty stuff.
Okay. Now what I want to do
is I'm going to set it up as if I'm going to eat it. I am going to, because this is hot, it's 9:24, turning this off. I need to put this in the refrigerator, so I need to cool down. So I have quite some time. I got laundry going, I got a lot of different things going. But what I am going to do is I'm going to show you me serving it. So I'm going to serve it in this bowl, and I'm going to use my scooper duper. And all right, so I'm going to do that. That can be washed actually, because I'm done. I'm good. So we got that off. I'm done tasting, so I don't need my tasters, right? So I'm going to put my top over here. I want it to cool off, and I'm going to take it off the hot burner. So that's that. All right, so with that, I'm going to move you. So, all right, so here's my bowl. Can you see that? Yes, you can. So here's my spoon. I'm going to set that. Now, so you can do a lot of things to make this taste yummy or bring it to your standards. Okay, so they suggest to have sour cream put on, and I'm going to do that. So I got some sour cream. I'm going to open this up. I got the light sour cream. That was my personal preference. I'm going to throw this away. I am going to put a dollop. What a dollop is basically a spoonful. Okay, it didn't go in the right place, but that's okay. A spoonful. Maybe two dollops. Okay, so I've got that. I use a spoon so I don't get another spoon at all. It also suggests putting some cheddar. I got mild cheddar, so I'm going to put mild cheddar on top. So I'm going to sprinkle that on top. Might as well put it all on. And I'm going to put this back in the fridge, mild cheddar. And I'm going to put my sour cream back in the fridge. Now, mind you, this is extremely hot, so I do want it to sit there for a little bit. Typically, I'm a big, big person about making sure food is warm when served. But I wanted to get this off. Okay. So that's off. All right. So now what I'm going to do is I like seasoning. So what I want to do is I'm going to put some pepper on there. I'm going to move you for just a split second. Sorry. That was a little bit wacky. So I'm going to take my salt. I have my salt grinder. Boop, boop. That's good. And I'm going to see if I can find some pepper. The first pepper I find, I will use. Sorry if all you're seeing is my chest or my sweatshirt. That is very frustrating, I am sure. I had no clue that I was going to have to go through such craziness to just get pepper. I thought pepper was right here. Hold on one second. Okay, I'm going to use my pepper right like this. Take the top off, and I'm going to grind some good old pepper in here. Yum, yum. There's no better way to do things than with a beautiful grinder. Okay. See, my hands are wet, and all the pepper is kind of going to my hands. And I'm like, there is no pepper going on.
All right. Well, I'm done.
Now, I'm going to try this
divineness. Look at, does that not look divine? You have sour cream. You have your cheese. Cheese, again, is protein. Tomatoes. What wonderful chili. Yum, yum in the tum tum. Okay. So, with that being said, I'm getting a spoonful. I'm sorry. I am getting a spoonful of stuff. It has everything on it. And you see? It's got the sour cream. It's got the cheese. It's got everything in the dish. And I'm going to blow on it because it's hot. Oh my God. Dear friends, bon appetit, my friends. Bon appetit. Love you. God bless.